Hello everyone, Barbara Zulli, Orange County, California. I'm here again with another video to tell you the answer for one of the questions I get from my YouTube audience, my website audience, and my students in I4I Academy about the ASME Section 8 Division 1 in the API 510 exam. How we can shorten the study time on the ASME Section 8 Division 1. The ASME Section 8 Division 1 is a huge content and covers all the aspect of the design, manufacturing, fabrication, and inspection and testing. And if you refer to the body of knowledge of the API for API 510 exam, you can see many of the clauses and contents of the ASME Section 8 Division 1 is included in the exam. And if you want to go through them, it takes days to learn all of those requirement or prohibitions. But as long as you learn the items that I'm calling in here, it might be enough for your API 510 exam. And instead of spending of days on studying of the ASME Section 8 Division 1, you just study few hours. The item that you need to know and learn about the ASME Section 8 Division 1 is one you should be able to calculate minimum required thickness for cylindrical shell and minimum required thickness for ellipsoidal head, minimum required thickness for hemispherical head. And then you need also to know what is the meaning of the RT1, what is the meaning of the RT2, what is the meaning of the RT3, and what is the meaning of the RT4. And you should also know when you are using the design formula on the joint efficiency, you have to put number 1 when it's RT1 or RT2, and put number 0.85 when it is RT3. And RT4 is depends. And then, in addition, you also need to know how to use PWHT table and how you can determine what is going to be holding time and holding temperature for post-weld heat treatment. You also need to know UW51 and UW52 for acceptance criteria of the radiography testing. So if you learn these things, I think this is going to be good enough for your API 510 exam. I'm going to put these items on description, on the video description, that you can go through the description and review this item that I mentioned to you. Things changed, the trend changed. Back in 2004 or 2005, those days, 10 years, 15 years, years ago, normally the ASME Section 8 Division 1 had a big role in the API 510 exam. But now that reduced. The pressure actually lifted from the ASME Section 8 Division 1 and placed on the API 510. So those days it was nozzle calculation, external pressure calculations, all was part of the exam. Now these days they all removed, and we're seeing each window time for exams less question from ASME Section 8 Division 1, and most of the questions are combined question between API 510 and ASME Section 8 Division 1, which I'm going to cover that on another video. So go down below to the description and review which item, which clause number that you need to know for your API 510 exam. And that might save you lots of time instead of going through the ASME Section 8 Division 1 and spending time for days and days and days. Then with the reviewing few items, you'll be able to cover what you need to know about the API 510 exam regarding the ASME Section 8 Division 1. One more advice for you guys is don't get hung up or obsessed with the ASME Section 8 Division 1. There are going to be limited questions from the ASME Section 8 Division 1. If we call about the direct question, it's going to be only maybe 2-3 questions, direct question, but there are going to be more questions which are the combined question between the API 510 and ASME Section 8 Division 1, which I'm going to cover another video. But my advice to you is don't get hung up, don't get obsessed with the ASME Section 8 Division 1. Just learn the item that I mentioned on this video, and that might be enough for your exam.